I was thinking of the symbol of giving a gift as a symbol in the Christmas story. And I was thinking of how nativity plays. I'm not an expert at this. I don't come from this tradition. But nativity plays often revolve around the story of the three wise men. And so I would just read Matthew 2:11, and it says, on coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And I was thinking of these things because the wise men came originally from the East. They actually had come from Persia, and they were also called the Magi. And they're, according to some of the research, came from the Zarathustrian religion. I hope I pronounced that right. And they had their roots in astrology and in magic. And I thought it's interesting because we often associate magic with deception, but this was actually magic of a different kind. This was the magic of giving, the magic of giving the gift. And in giving the gifts, it opens the heart in a magical way. And we are here in our various ways, in our traditions, in our backgrounds, here to give the gift, to open the heart in a magical way, to allow something of the magic of gift giving, to allow a greater sharing at another level. And I thought it's interesting that they also call them wise men, the three wise men. And I thought there's actually a wisdom in giving gifts, in giving the gift. It actually requires us to be wise in how we give the gift, in what we give, and what our intention is. And also realize that it actually has an effect on other people's lives, what we offer, what we give. We're here to give. And I thought there's actually a joy in generosity. There's a joy in giving. There's a joy in knowing that your gift is going to make a difference in the life of another person. And so there definitely is wisdom in giving our gift, whether you be a man or a woman, it doesn't make any difference. There is wisdom there. And I thought there's also joy in being generous. There's joy in generosity, in exchange, in flow. And giving the gift means that we are sharing in exchange and flow. We're actually lifting something up, and we need to give not to impress anybody or to make a statement of some sort, not to be sucked into the whole commercialization of what Christmas is, but rather seeing it as a spiritual act, the spiritual act of offering something to somebody else. And there are many ways that we can do it. And I thought, yes, we've all seen what we call in South Africa, the American model of Christmas, all the decorations in the shopping malls, et cetera. But it's actually something that goes beyond giving to meet expectation, but rather as an act of generosity, as an act of expression, as an act of blessing. And I thought, what difference it can make to another person. And that is certainly part of the Christmas story that we have in our lives today, is that what we have to offer has spiritual essence behind our giving. And we are here to give with a consciousness of the expression of our quality of spirit that is transformative, that makes a difference, that is a blessing. And there's a lot to give. And there are many ways we can do this. I was thinking of, I actually mentioned even this morning, is that one can just bake bread and share it. I remember one of the most magnificent meals I had was just bread, butter, and a product we have in South Africa you don't have in America called Marmite, and which is somewhat similar to a spread like peanut butter, but a lot more sour. But the act of what had gone into creating the meal, and it was the most simple meal there ever was. But the act of sharing that with good coffee and bread and the spread on top, those type of things can be magical in their ways. And so we can share in a way that is magical, that is special, and that can uplift. And whether it's baking bread or biscuits, or whether it's any other way that my wife is far more creative than I am in the act of giving, and far more in tune with what giving is in the context of Christmas. But that doesn't matter. We're all here to offer something in spirit, in our giving. And we are bringing blessing in doing that. And so there's more to the Christmas story than just sort of going through the motions of it because it's commercialized. We are here to express something that is true and carries the spirit of Christmas.